Now I train twice daily, 6 times a week. I'm doing it because it's who I am. Psychology and neuroscience research show that internalizing an active identity is one of the most powerful predictors of long-term exercise adherence. This identity shift is deeply embedded in our neurobiology. The prefrontal cortex, the brain's planning and decision-making center. For my first workout of the day, it all begins after I brush my teeth in the morning. Dopamine, the brain's primary motivational neurotransmitter, isn't just released after a reward, it spikes before the action itself. The brain releases dopamine not just for the reward itself, but in expectation of it. If you're struggling with consistency, then please do not rely on motivation and discipline alone. Please try these tools because these are proven ways that you can increase your gym adherence. At 15, I walked into the gym for the first time, and honestly, the environment was a bit intimidating. I had no structured plan and no clear motivation, so it would have been very, very easy for me to just quit. Instead, I found a way to make fitness into a permanent part of my life. It was a shift in identity. I stopped seeing training as something that I just did, and I started seeing it as something that I am. Psychology and neuroscience research show that internalizing an active identity is one of the most powerful predictors of long-term exercise adherence. A 2024 study of 1,709 adults validated the exercise identity scale and found that those who strongly identified as exercisers were 2.5 times more likely to maintain a consistent training routine. The study used a rating system from -3, which meant weak identity, to +3, which meant strong identity, and revealed that individuals who successfully maintained weight loss scored significantly higher than those who struggled to stay active. This identity shift is deeply embedded in our neurobiology. The prefrontal cortex, the brain's planning and decision-making center, consolidates self-narratives, reinforcing behaviors that align with identity. Meanwhile, the basal ganglia, responsible for habit formation, plays a crucial role in making exercise automatic. Studies show that once behaviors are repeated enough times, the basal ganglia takes over, reducing the mental effort required to make a decision. This is why people who identify as lifters or athletes find it easier to stay consistent. They've wired their brains to see exercise as a fundamental part of who they are. I experienced this transformation firsthand because in the beginning, I was super inconsistent with my gym adherence. But after a prolonged period of time, my identity started to shift, and thus my adherence actually went way up. This mirrors findings from a 2021 randomized controlled trial on 276 women, which demonstrated that 16 weeks of regular exercise significantly increased exercise identity strength. Even 6 months later, participants who underwent structured training continued to engage in an extra 16 minutes of weekly exercise compared to the control group. Now I train twice daily, 6 times a week, and I'm not even forcing myself to do it. I'm doing it because it's who I am. And I know you guys are probably thinking that that's way too much. You're probably killing yourself. You probably hate it. But no, I actually genuinely look forward to each and every session. And it's not like I'm doing like two-hour prolonged workouts every week. It's just one workout that's split up into two. And I love every single minute of it. And I look forward to it every day. Identity is the foundation, but habits are the glue that keeps the consistency intact as you propel yourself forward. Over time, I made my training a non-negotiable by actually implementing it into my daily routine. One of the most effective strategies that I used is called habit stacking, and it's just where you're going to be linking your gym session to an already existing routine. For example, for my first workout of the day, it all begins after I brush my teeth in the morning. Once I do a couple things first, and then I pick up the toothbrush and brush my teeth, then I immediately get ready, grab my gym bag, and go. This works because habits are formed through cue action reward loops governed by the basal ganglia. A 2021 randomized controlled trial tested the effectiveness of structured habit cues versus generic advice and found that those who paired workouts with existing routines had 40% higher adherence post-intervention. The phrase neurons that fire together, wire together principle applies here. Repeatedly linking a workout to a cue strengthens neural pathways, making the behavior automatic over time. Studies show that habits formed this way require far less cognitive effort to maintain. But what's the reason? Well, when a behavior becomes automated, the prefrontal cortex, which is the decision-making center, disengages, shifting control to the basal ganglia, which operates on autopilot. This is why brushing your teeth or driving a familiar route requires little thought. You've done it so many times before that the action no longer requires conscious effort. By integrating training into my routine with a consistent cue, I ensured that my workouts became just as automatic. Willpower is so overrated. What really cements consistency is finding true intrinsic enjoyment out of the process. The brain is so wired to seek rewards that exercise really needs to be reframed as something that is desirable instead of something that's just a throwaway to-do list that almost feels like a chore. Dopamine, the brain's primary motivational neurotransmitter, isn't just released after a reward. It spikes before the action itself, creating anticipation and drive. A 2024 study of 345 college students found that when workouts were linked to intrinsic rewards, adherence increased by as much as 27%. This phenomenon is explained by dopamine's role in predictive coding. The brain releases dopamine not just for the reward itself, but in expectation of it. When I started associating workouts with learning and relaxation, my brain began craving the gym just like it craves coffee in the morning. Another key driver of gym adherence is the feeling of progress. Psychologically, humans have an innate need for competence. They need to be feeling like they're improving at something. This is why tracking my workouts was one of the best things that I ever did. A 2024 longitudinal study of 1,451 adolescents found that exercise intensity predicted future physical activity, not the other way around. The study's four-wave cross-lag model revealed that individuals who tracked their progress, whether through lifting numbers, visual changes, or performance milestones, experienced stronger engagement in their prefrontal cortex, the area responsible for planning and motivation. Those who regularly tracked progress saw a 22% lower dropout rate over the course of a year. Beyond motivation, tracking progress also will spike the neurotransmitter dopamine, which will further reinforce that habit loop. Every PR, every extra rep, every achievement, no matter how big or small, is going to provide a micro reward, which is going to keep you engaged and keep you coming back. Humans are social creatures, and research shows that training with others massively increases gym adherence. Whenever I lift with my friends, my gym workouts become more than just a training session. They become more of a shared and fun experience. This is largely driven by oxytocin, the social bonding hormone. A 2023 study on older adults found that group-based exercise programs reduced the dropout rates by 65% compared to solo training. Oxytocin strengthens trust and connection, making shared activities more rewarding. The anterior cingulate cortex, a region involved in social behavior, becomes more active during group workouts, reinforcing commitment to the habit. If you're struggling with consistency, then please do not rely on motivation and discipline alone. Please try some, if not all, and I would recommend doing all of these tools, because these are proven ways that you can increase your gym adherence.